Hello everybody, welcome back to another class on Verbling. We're going to be doing a role play class on the phone because they're all going to be appointments or discussions that you typically have in English over the phone. So that's what we're going to practice doing together. Should be fun, should be interesting. Hello, Daniel, welcome back.
Hi, AB, how are you doing?
I'm doing good, good to see you again. What's new?
Everything is fine.
Everything's fine?
Yeah.
Good. Nice to have you back. Thank you for joining us. Giovanni, thanks. Welcome.
Hi, Abby. How are you?
What happened to the dark room?
Nothing. It's the same.
You just don't want to show us today.
Just a moment. My
camera. Good to have you back, Giovanni. Thank you for joining us. We're happy to have you.
So, this is my dark room.
The dark room still exists. It lives on. Long live the dark room. Leonardo, welcome.
Hello, Hebby. What's up?
Hey, look at you, all fluent in your English. I am pretty good. What's up with you?
Oh, the same thing. Same routine.
Same old, same old. Well, that's okay. That's better than bad news.
Of course.
Hi, Lucas. Welcome back.
Hi, Abby.
Hey, hey. How you feeling today?
Like before. Good.
Good? Okay. I thought maybe there was a drastic change between then and now.
No, no.
Maybe you fell down the stairs or something terrible happened.
I had the lesson with Lisa. Okay.
Oh, good. Well, Lisa kept you safe then. I'm glad to hear it.
Yes.
And Jorge, welcome back. How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you, Avi.
Good. What did you do today, Jorge?
I've been taking some verbaling classes and doing other things.
Cool. Well, it's good to have you. Thanks for joining us again. Ali, what's a role play?
What's a role play?
What's a role play?
Role play? Mm-hmm. Role play, you give a scenario to people and people acting who in the scenario pretend something like them.
Absolutely. You act like characters that you are not actually a part of, right? Who can think of something in life that requires that we do role plays? Besides learning English, what else might we do in life that includes a role play?
About skills.
Okay, what kinds of skills?
Maybe fantasy.
Fantasies?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
No, I mean, have a lot of improvisation.
Improvising, that's true, improvising. What about if you were training to be a doctor, what kind of role play might you see happen in that kind of training? What do you guys think?
You have to simulate the emergency situations, but to be prepared when that happens.
Exactly. So you might see a simulation of an emergency situation. I remember taking a first aid course, and that was exactly what we did. We had to role play, act out a terrible emergency, had a plan, being calm, etc., etc. Has anyone else ever done a role play in a different situation like that?
I don't know, I mean, a role play of a good son, maybe, in the house.
A role play of what? Sorry, Daniel, again?
A good son.
A good son in a house.
Yeah, maybe with your parents, or you gotta be polite, or I don't know.
Okay, son, probably. Let's practice going to visit grandma. How do we talk to grandma? Go ahead, no. Giovanni, what were you going to say? Giovanni?
I remember the lesson yesterday. You took a lesson about, I don't remember, there was a cemetery and grandmother. So it's a sort of deja vu. Sorry.
Sort of a deja vu, yeah. Maybe you won't have to role play that in normal life, but yeah. Tiago, welcome to the class. How are you?
Hey, Abby. I'm fine. And you?
Good to see you again.
Oh, good to see you too.
Tiago, can you think of an example of when people use role plays in education? Maybe not learning a language like we're doing today, but another time when they use a role play to help you learn or practice something?
A person, like a teacher, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I used to be part of a theater group when I was at university, and it was pretty wild, you know? Yeah.
Were these after-hour role plays, Tiago?
any crazy stuff, you know? We used to act like waiting for Godot, you know, these kind of things. Like
waiting for what, sorry?
For Godot, I guess. I don't know the title in English. It's a play from Harold Pinter. And absurd theater or something.
Okay. Thanks for sharing. Very good. Anyone else think of another example of when you might do a role play?
When you want to joke someone or prank someone, you can do role plays.
Yeah, that's another good one, Ali. Have you ever seen that happen?
Yeah, sometimes we send our friends, for example, a shop, and they are thinking like government officers, and say to shoppers, they are our friend also, and show your documents and something like that.
Because so that might prepare her, to prepare her for being less nervous.
Yeah.
When I was a kid, me and my friend, we used to pretend that we were foreigners in Canada, and so we'd speak some gibberish language and pretend that we were asking for directions or we needed help. Wild. Just to get a reaction out of people. Different ways that people pretend to be somebody that they're actually not, right? Has anyone here ever been involved in theater or acting or anything like that?
I have a short experience in the childhood. At the final years of my first period as a student, I took place in a scene as an actor, mm-hmm. a small role.
So Giovanni, did you think, oh, I might have a career in acting? Did you think that maybe that was a possibility for you?
For me?
Yeah.
I don't know, maybe in the comic theater.
Where people laugh at you and throw tomatoes at you?
Yeah. Don't joke. Tiago said, don't joke.
Just joking. I'm sure you were great. Okay, so what we're going to do today is sometimes when you're speaking English on the telephone, it's a little bit more challenging than speaking to somebody in real person. So we're going to practice simulating different situations that are typical on the phone. So if anyone were to travel to a country where it was English speaking and need to use these skills, and we're going to try to make it fun. Obviously, we're going to joke around a little bit because not everybody is in a situation where they'll have to make a doctor's appointment in English, but we're still going to practice it, okay? Any questions before we start?
No. Let's start.
Okay, let's get into it. Jorge, what do you mean when we lie?
Yeah, when you are when you pretend to be another person or you try to supplant someone in a situation that you are not the real person.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a kind of role-playing, that's for sure. I never really thought of that. Very true. So let's take a look. I'm going to share my screen with you. Just one second here. Okay. So for each of the role plays, we're actually going to add some details. And everyone is going to practice by adding the details for us.
Okay.
Let's see here. Just a second. Let's look at one practice round, just so we can see how these things might go. Okay, for example, making a hair appointment. Maybe we could have Ali. Do you want to be the receptionist? And Tiago, you can be Sue.
Yeah. Okay. I am the receptionist.
Sure. Yep.
Ali, receptionist. Tiago, Sue.
Mm-hmm. Ah, okay.
Okay. We start?
Yep. Go ahead. Read that first one for us.
Okay. Good morning. Spare Cuts Hair Salon. Can I help you?
Oh, hi, babe. I'd like to make a hair appointment, please.
Okay. When can you come in?
Tomorrow morning, gorgeous.
Okay. We have an opening for tomorrow, Wednesday, March 19th at 10:30 a.m.
Ooh, great. I'll take it.
What's your name?
Sue Nelson.
See you then.
Good job. Nicely done. See, we need people like Tiago and Ali in the class who play along, right? They take their character and they run with it. Tiago, do you have your...
No, I don't have it. I don't have it. I'm sorry.
Oh, what a disappointment.
I'm at work right now.
Okay, you better behave yourself. So there's an idea of how the role play might go, except for this role play was not very exciting. We're going to make our role plays super exciting, okay? The first one is, actually, let's go to the second one, canceling a dentist appointment. So we need one person to be the receptionist and the other to be a patient, and we need to think of some ideas. What would be some possible reasons for canceling a dentist appointment? Lucas, tell me some possible reasons.
To be sick. Hello?
Hello, can you hear me?
To be sick or... Yes?
Yes.
Okay, being sick. One reason for canceling. Who can think of another reason? What's another reason for canceling a dentist appointment?
Oh, because my tooth stopped to hurt.
My tooth stopped hurting.
Yes.
Excellent. Jorge, another reason.
Because you are...
You are afraid. Absolutely. You're going, my God, not the dentist, please. But
you need an excuse.
Giovanni, another reason?
I don't know. For a live concert.
Going to a live concert. Good. They might not like that one. Daniel, what's another excuse?
I don't know. Maybe your cat died. Your little cat.
My cat died. Oh, Ali, another one.
Maybe you have a meeting or dating something.
Have a meeting, maybe with work, okay? And
schedule conflict.
Okay, scheduling conflict. And Alex, welcome back to the class. Good to see you.
Hi, Abby. How are you?
Are you all by yourself, or did you bring the posse?
Okay, no. It's okay.
What's another reason for canceling?
For example, I crashed my car.
I crashed my car.
I crashed my car.
Perfect. Okay, so now the idea is the patient has to choose an excuse, but the office receptionist, how might they respond? Tiago, what are some possible responses from the office receptionist?
We can schedule it for next week.
They want to schedule for next week. Okay, so that means they're okay with it. Okay, well, we can schedule it for next week. What else? Anyone else think of a way that the receptionist might respond?
If he canceled the appointment, he would have a penalty.
Perfect.
A cash penalty.
He has to pay a cash penalty if he cancels. Perfect. Very common. Anyone
because
else think of a
to,
different...
Because you have to... Because you have to how can I say? You have to say 24 hours before.
Need 24 hours notice. You could say 24 hours notice. Okay, something's ringing on my computer. I'm not sure what it is. Okay, sorry about that. Something was calling me. I had no idea what it was. Okay, so 24 hours notice. Perfect. Let's go with that. So let's have Daniel. You're going to be the office receptionist, okay?
Okay.
You're the office receptionist.
Sorry, what is a Corsair?
Pardon?
What is a Corsair?
A concert?
Corsair.
Oh, Corsair. I'm not sure, Tiago. Tiago, can you tell us what you mean? Is it a dentist or a?
Oh, yeah. It's because he wants money, right? The Corsair is like a pirate in the old times.
Okay.
Sack the ships and things like that.
Right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, so here's the information for the dentist office, and here's the date and time of the appointment. But Lucas decides that he needs to cancel. So anything you guys would like to add to the personalities of our characters? Okay, Lucas is going to be carefree. Daniel is going to be strict and has poor customer service. Okay? Let's give it a go. Lucas, phone Dr. Shell's office and cancel your dentist appointment for one of the reasons above.
Okay. Hello, this is Dr. Shell's office.
Good morning. AB is dentist's office. How can I help you?
I wanted to reschedule my appointment because I can't go to visit.
Why? What is the reason?
I have a very important meeting, so it's very important to me that I can change my appointment to tomorrow, if it's okay, or maybe you can told me some other date.
I think it's impossible because AB's schedule is absolutely booked for the next month, and then she's gonna travel to Brazil for around 3 months. So there's no way I can change it.
And now I don't know what to say. there is not only one dentist in this city. I don't know. I think it's possible to change appointment because you wanted to lose the your lawyer client.
Look. I got a space for the next week, a free slot. But you gotta pay $200 fee.
$200. Oh my God. Maybe we can change the price to some normal.
That's normal
price.
We are in specials. $200.
For me it's not a good price. The price it's not exactly correct. You could look at the at the price. And because I think you told me the mistake.
Well, the trouble here is that I'm just a receptionist. If you want it, wait here for 5 minutes. I will speak with Abby, with Dr. Abby, before.
Okay, I would be very thankful if you could speak with her and maybe change the price, because if the price will be still the same, I need to change the dentist.
Okay, Dr. AB said that the price can be $100 instead of $200, because you're a special customer for her.
Could you repeat the price?
$100.
Oh, it's better. But maybe we can.
And she's gonna give you a candy, a free candy. We got a deal, or?
So it's impossible to negotiate the price.
No, we are not in a grocery store. This is a dentist's office.
So very sorry. I need to change the dentist. I'm very sorry.
Okay, so stop making me waste my time.
Okay,
I
don't recommend this.
What is okay. Dr. Abby is the best dentist in town. Good job, you guys. That was fantastic. Good questions. Good, even bargaining with the dentist receptionist. Lucas, I'm impressed. I don't know where you learned those skills, but you did a really good job. Does anyone have any questions?
I'm not good with role plays, but so.
You did awesome. You did really, really well. You, your English was great. I understood you. What do you guys think about the role play? What do you think Lucas could have said? If this was a real life situation, what would you do if you were in Lucas's position? Who wants to tell me?
He could. Oh my God. He could make a complaint.
Okay. He could make a complaint or put in a complaint?
Yes.
Awesome. Very good. Anyone else have a different idea of how he could deal with that situation? Sue the office. Okay. Who here lives in an area where if you cancel your appointments within a certain period of time, you have to pay a penalty? Who here lives in an area where they have to do that?
I know, never.
No penalty here.
Okay. Giovanni, you're going to be student A. Leonardo.
Yes.
You're going to be student B for our next role play. So let's head down there. Rescheduling.
My appointment.
My appointment. So there's different reasons scheduling. You can use the list above. Let me copy and paste reasons that you need to reschedule. Who would like to add something to the role play? Maybe something to Giovanni's character or something to Leandro's character.
Sorry, teacher, I don't understand.
What don't you understand, Giovanni?
Your last phrase
to take the license, the driver license.
He needs the driver's license? Oh, okay, very good, Jorge. Okay, so the reason that Leonardo needs to have an eye appointment is he needs to re-qualify for his driver's license.
Maybe the receptionist can be corrupt, a corrupt person. She would accept a bribe.
Okay. I like it. I love corruption.
maybe.
Okay, and the receptionist. Accepts a bribe. Okay, let's hear it.
So I'm the patient.
You are the patient.
Okay. Hello.
Hello, this is Dr. Smith's office. Who are you?
Hello, I'm Leonardo. Sorry if I'm not... I'm not wrong, I have reserved one appointment for Friday, but I want rescheduling it.
Okay, just a moment, please.
Okay. I hate this sound. Anyways, I have to wait. Jesus Christ.
Hey, are you listening to me?
Oh, yes.
Okay, it's true. I see your name. Can you repeat it, please? Can you repeat it?
Leonardo.
Okay, Leonardo.
Yes.
What do you want?
I want rescheduling my hair appointment because I'm busy for Friday.
For Friday?
Yes.
Just a moment, please. And when do you want to reschedule your appointment?
It's possible for Saturday in the morning. Not in the afternoon, please, because in the evening I must go to the party, so I can't go.
Just a moment, please.
Thank you.
Oh, sorry. Unfortunately, we can also you have a space all in the afternoon.
Oh my God! I have to miss my party.
What party?
It's a party between friends, you know.
Are there many girls?
Sorry.
Are there many girls?
Maybe. I hope so.
Are you sure?
You will come?
I don't know. Mm-hmm. So, unfortunately, I see the schedule.
Okay.
We don't have a space, but I don't know.
Okay, it doesn't matter. What about in Monday?
In Monday? No, it's full. It's full, no space.
Also in Monday? Come on, man. My head is hurt. I need to you.
Where is your party?
Sorry?
Where is the party?
The party, it's in my house.
And
in my garden.
Oh, nice.
Thank you.
And is it close to the to our office?
Sorry?
Is your garden in your house close to our office?
No, yes, my garden, it's in my house.
Yes, but your house is close to our office. How many distance?
I think 2 hours by car.
Oh.
It's enough far.
So long.
Yes. Anyway, I have my car. I have a Porsche. No problem.
You can, I don't know, maybe you can... You can take me a passage, for example.
Sorry? A passage?
You can come in here and you can take me a passage for the party. I don't know.
Oh, okay. Not a problem for me. I can be here in 10 minutes. I drive very fast.
Oh, be careful. I don't know.
Yes, of course. Be careful. Okay, good job, you guys. Actually, wait towards the end. I was having difficulty with my connection. What happened at the end, Ali? How did he end up getting the appointment from, like, right now?
Because the receptionist wants to join his party. And he want to him take he is the party and he agree. Yeah.
So there really was an appointment available.
Yes.
Interesting. Very interesting. Okay. Good job, you guys. That was awesome. I only missed that one little part where I couldn't hear what.
Oh.
With the
what's that?
She had connection problem.
She go to the dentist.
Doctor Abby.
Ali, play the teacher role playing now.
Ali, last time I killed your plant. You remember?
Oh, yes, you killed my babies.
Yes.
That's what's happened.
I punished you, don't remember?
Oh, yes. I still suffer for your punition.
Yeah.
What kind of punishment?
It's better you don't know.
Verbal punishment?
Yes, some kind of.
Hey, Abby.
The teacher have a connection problem.
Are you okay?
We can't hear you, Abby.
AB, are you there?
What's the next scenario? Making a car inspection appointment.
I'm here.
I am a car.
Hey, Abby.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
What happened?
You are a car?
What happened? I my connection dropped me. It's my fault. Sorry about that, you guys. I think it's Jorge and Alex next, okay? So let's continue with Jorge and Alex. Let me just turn my...
Syndrome?
Okay.
Alex, you're going to be student A.
Student...
A. And Jorge, you are going to be student B. 1 second here.
Okay.
That was good, you guys. I don't know what I missed. I hope you guys weren't talking about me when I dropped. Talking about me behind my back.
Are you? We talk about make
okay.
situations.
Sorry, Jorge. What were you gonna say?
No, no, that's okay. I thought you. I couldn't watch your screen.
Okay. Is it okay now? Everything's good?
Yes.
Great. Yeah. Making a car inspection appointment.
Yes. So, Alex, you are the receptionist, and Jorge, you are the caller. You need to come up with some weird idea for why your car needs an inspection, okay? Now, what do we know about sometimes when you take your car in for an inspection? Why do you end up spending more money than you planned? Why does that happen sometimes?
Sorry, Abby, who I am?
Alex, you are the office receptionist.
Okay. Office receptionist. Okay.
Exactly. Okay.
Or has a lemon.
He has a lemon car.
Lemon car.
Has a lemon car, which is a car that has constant problems. Okay, Jorge? So you're getting really frustrated.
Okay.
Frustrated. Okay?
Okay.
And Alex, you are trying to make as much money as possible.
Okay, right.
Okay. Go ahead.
Expensive. Right. Okay.
Hello. Is this GIL Automobile?
Yes. Is it? What is your problem?
Well, I'm coming here because I have a problem with my car. I think he's whacked out. It's not working well.
Okay, where is your car? It's closer or far?
No, actually, my car is far, but I don't know if you have a truck that can take my car to the the garage.
Okay. Do you need an inspection in this place? But this rate is expensive.
Yeah, but at the same time, I need you can figure out the problem of my car.
Uh-huh, okay. I need to take more of 3 buses. When did you need an appointment? Today or tomorrow?
I need the appointment as soon as possible.
Sorry?
I need the appointment as soon as possible.
Yeah. Ah, okay. Let me see my agent. Let me see. Okay. It's possible today in the afternoon. But...
Oh, nice.
But it's more expensive today. No problem?
How much?
$50 more.
$50?
Yeah.
But I think my insurance...
I have work.
My insurance covered that situation. I think I don't have to pay for an extra charge.
I'm alone in my garage. I have much work, but if you can't to pay this rate, I'm going to go. I will go.
I'm going to pay after you pay car.
Okay. this afternoon I'm going to go off to your house. I take my bicycle. I'm going to go to the house. Okay?
Oh, come on! A bicycle? It's not a serious mechanic company?
Sorry, my motorcycle is damaged.
No, my God. It's the worst service I have.
At this moment, I only have a bicycle. You need to repair your car. No problem.
But what happens if you can you can fix my car? You need to take my car to at your garage.
Oh, sorry. Doesn't matter. Okay. I don't know. I think that in 2 hours I'll be in here.
Okay. I'm going to wait here.
You don't worry. Okay?
Okay. This is an interesting role play, you guys. A mechanic with no vehicle that works. Mm-hmm. And poor Jorge, who's trying to get the best deal to get his car fixed. Good job, you guys. Very, very well done. What's a tow truck? A tow truck. Adela, welcome. And tell us, what's a tow truck?
I don't know. I don't know, sorry.
A tow truck. You can see it in the chat there.
I hope to never see a hope truck.
A what truck? A hope truck. Not a hope truck, a tow truck. Okay.
It's a car.
Go ahead.
Truck. You carry another truck, maybe.
Exactly.
Broken truck. Broken car, something like that.
We call them the wrecker. The wrecker. So if you park in the wrong place, like Tiago says, what do they do, Tiago, to your vehicle if you park in the wrong place?
They tow your car?
Mm-hmm. They remove it. And then you have to pay, at least in Canada, $100 to get your vehicle back.
Yeah.
So do not park it in the wrong place is the message, right?
Yeah, indeed. Yeah.
Perfect. Another word I'd like you to repeat, Jorge, is garage.
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 It's okay if I say garage when I'm talking about, the place that mechanic works. Mm-hmm,
absolutely. The perfect word. You use the correct word. I'm just helping you on your pronunciation, which is garage.
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 Okay, and if you're from Britain, it's a garage.
Oh, yeah.
Garage. Okay?
Really?
Yeah. Okay. You don't believe me?
No, it's like... I believe you, of course.
Oh, my gosh. Really? I don't
know. It sounds American, yeah. It sounds American.
You want to mess with me? Okay. Just
Are you playing a role?
I'm playing the role play of a gangster now. You messing with me? Okay. Next is going to be Adela and Tiago. Okay, so let's go to our next role play scenario. You are canceling a hair appointment, okay? The place, the date, the time. Adela, you are the receptionist. Tiago, you're the caller.
Wow.
You're canceling your buzz cut.
That's very well, Abby.
Tiago, what have I told you? You've got a beautiful bald head. You look great.
Oh, thank you very much. You made my day right now.
let's go go ahead. Adela, you're the office receptionist, so you want to have good customer service skills. But Tiago, you're a little bit, you've got a bad excuse, and you tell the receptionist, which is not, doesn't make her very happy. So whatever bad excuse you can think of, okay?
Okay.
Go ahead.
Gorgeous salon, Adela speak. Can I help you?
Yeah, babe, you can help me. I would like to cancel my haircut today, you know. Is that right? I want to cancel that. To get it right.
And what is your date? When have you the appointment?
I guess my day is today. It's in the afternoon. You can search for Mr. Tiago Dessa Moreira Santos Silva João José Ribeiro Pombal.
So long.
That's my name, babe.
30 p.m. But it's a very late canceling. You need to pay a tax because it's a problem for the hairdresser.
You mean
we can have another client. This is not possible so late.
I just got that you're gonna pay me a taxi. Wow, this hair salon's great.
Yes, to cancel is at least 10 hours. 10 hours. Sorry, for 10 hours to have time to call another client, to have all people, because
No, I'm not old, babe. No way. I'm in my 20s. You know, how can you say something like that? Ever in your life.
This problem. This is the rules about the hairdresser. For all people. It's not possible to have a different thing with you. Sorry. It's not my fault. I'm not the boss. I only an employee.
You're just joking, right? You're kidding me. Just because I'm bald and you think I don't need a haircut? Of course I need a haircut, babe. I'm doing some, you know, procedures and my hair is growing. So you mean I'm bald and you don't want to cut my hair? That's what I'm saying, huh? Is that right? Is that what you're saying? What's your name? What's your social security number? I'm calling my lawyer right now. Okay.
Yes, you can talk with the lawyer. If you don't agree with the rules, you can make a complaint. But it's not for me. It's the boss, the AWM, is the rules. Sorry.
No, but you can break the rules. Come on. You know. We are not in Canada, babe. We're in Brazil. You know. It happens all the time, you know. I can't introduce you.
Hey, babe.
Babe.
Sorry.
Adela, you were awesome. Good job. You held up to that. He was a difficult customer. And being a receptionist for hairstylists is not easy. They're very demanding people. So, Tiago, take it easy on her.
I'm sorry.
I'm going to start calling you Tiaga.
It's He's a very hard client.
Okay, yeah, so
yeah.
He is Adela. You should have told him, never come back. Leave and never come back.
I repeat.
Good job. Leonardo, what was the reason? What did Tiago say was the reason that they didn't want to cut his hair? He said, just because I'm what?
Because the hair are growing.
Yeah. I don't understand they're growing, the hair are growing.
He said, Adela, he said, it's just because I'm bald, but I'm going through a procedure and my hair is growing. That's yeah. The truth. He's a difficult client.
Yes.
Perfect. Good job, you guys. I loved your expressions. Tiago, your attitude, I almost had to jump in there and break up a fight, but I'm glad I didn't have to do it.
Yeah, Abby, sorry about that. It's just
that's okay. A person, yeah, I forgive you. Okay, Ali, me and you are going to have to follow that one. Ali, we are arranging to meet. What's going on? Why are you laughing? Did I miss something?
Read them.
What? Why is everyone laughing without me?
No, I read the Alex Obregon sentence.
Ali's sentence.
The dream people to the Irish Saloon.
No, Alex.
Oh, okay. Is your dream to go to the Irish Saloon? Oh my goodness, I can tell that it's the end of the workday for me. I'm starting to get a little bit crazy. Ali, it's you and me. Are you ready? We are the last ones to do our role play.
Yeah.
You're student A. No, I'm student A, and I'm going to invite you to meet me for coffee, but you're not available, and you have to give me some excuses, okay?
Yes, okay.
So what are some possible excuses? You guys can maybe help him out in the chat. I'm not going to be using the chat because I'm going to be fully in character, okay? 100% in character.
Have to take a range
okay,
because
Ali.
We have plans.
He's got plans. Okay, tell him in the chat. Tell him in the chat so we can get started. Hi, Ali. It's Abby. How are you?
Hi, Abby. I am fine. Thank you. How are you?
I'm so good. It's so good to see you. You know, I was thinking we need to get together. We should go to the coffee shop. Do you wanna?
Maybe. When you want to meet with me?
It's Thursday. Well, I'm off work. Why don't we go on Sunday at 2:00 in the afternoon? We'll go to that Buck's coffee shop around the corner. You wanna go there?
Let me think. Sunday at 2 p.m.
Why are you thinking so much, Ali? Don't you want to have coffee with me?
No, I want. You know, I like you, but I think I have a schedule on Sunday afternoon. I promise a friend to meet with them, with him.
A girlfriend?
No, he is not a girl. He is one of my best friends. He needs help, my help. I meet with him.
Well, what's his name?
His name is Leonardo.
Leonardo?
Yeah.
What?
How long have you been seeing him for?
He is my one of my old friends.
Well, how come I've never heard of him before?
Really?
Well, me and you have been friends for a long time. I've never heard of Leonardo.
Didn't I tell about him? Never?
I think I'd remember. Who makes plans on a Sunday afternoon? Are you sure you already have plans?
Yes, I am sure. Why are you asking?
Ah, well, that's too bad, Ali. My mom was going to come, too. My mom really wanted to come for coffee with us.
Oh, okay. Let me speak with Leonardo if I cancel my meeting with him. We can meet and drink coffee together, okay?
Well, wait a second. Maybe Leonardo would like to come. My mom is single.
maybe I will ask him.
Okay.
Ask Leonardo, I'll recall back you later, okay?
That sounds great. Thanks, Ali. We'll see you 2 o'clock at Buck's Coffee Shop, okay?
Okay,
don't be late.
yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Good job, Ali. Nicely done.
Your wishes are order for me, Ali.
Pardon?
I said your wishes are order for me.
Your wish? You can say your wish is my command. Good job. You guys, that was really good. You're getting better at your role plays, your role playing activities, I have to say. So, my glasses. Good. Any questions or comments about what we saw in the role plays today? Okay. Good job, you guys. Congratulations on a job well done.